ओम श्री सरस्वते नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मवित्वरम्। हरि ओम टू यू ऑल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस विवेक चूड़ामणि। यू हैव बीन डूइंग द स्टडी ऑफ दिस टेक्स्ट एंड आई हैव बीन टोल्ड दैट आई मस्ट टेल द एसेंस ऑफ दिस big text. It has got 580 plus verses, so it is very difficult, very tough job to tell in short the essence of entire book, but I will try to tell something. See, this Vivek Chudamani, it's a prakaran grantha. Prakaran grantha means book of categories, or it is also called as topical text. There are two types of text. One is called shastra or scripture, and other is called prakaran grantha or book of category. When we say shastra, Shastra deals with all the topics related to that particular subject. For example, when I say Sangeet Shastra, it is a book of Sangeet Shastra. Means all the thoughts and all the topics related to music have been given in that book. Jyotish Shastra, Bhautik Shastra. So all the topics are included in the scripture. Or shastra. And when we say adhyatma shastra, a spiritual text, that has got almost 9 topics. Scripture deals with 9 topics. And this prakaran grantha is based on that scripture. So in prakaran grantha also, broadly, these 9 topics are discussed. And what are those 9 topics? So they say in Adhyatma Shastra, the first topic is Shishya Lakshana, qualities of a seeker, qualifications of a seeker, Shishya Lakshana. Second is Guru Lakshana, characteristics of a competent teacher. We must know who is the ideal teacher. Third thing is Guru Pasadan, his method of approaching to that teacher. There is a method, there is a particular way in which we must approach to that great saint. So that is called Guru Pasakti or Guru Pasadam. Then the fourth topic is Tat Tvam Pad Vichara. Tvam Pad Vichara. You must have heard the statement Tat Tvam Asi. So in that statement, Tvam word comes. And Tvam means you and me, individual. So who am I? What is my real nature? What is the empirical reality about me? So that is Tvam Pad Vichara has been given. Discussion about myself. And next topic is Tat Pad Vichara. Tat. Tat means that. That supreme reality, that Brahman, that God. So that topic has been discussed. एंड द नेक्स्ट इज असी तत्वम असी असी पद विचार असी मीन्स वननेस बिटवीन तत् एंड त्वम वननेस बिटवीन इंडिविजुअल एंड दैट सुप्रीम ब्रह्मा विच इज कॉल्ड जीव ब्रह्मैक्य बोध एकत्व वननेस आइडेंटिटी सो फर्स्ट इज गुरु लक्षण सेकंड इज फर्स्ट इज शिष्य लक्षण सेकंड इज गुरु लक्षण थर्ड इज गुरुप सदन फोर्थ इज त्वम पद विचार फिफ्थ इज तत्पद विचार सिक्स्थ इज वननेस बिटवीन त्वम एंड तत् देन सेवंथ टॉपिक इज साधन विचार हाउ आई कैन रियलाइज दिस वननेस वॉट आर द मीन्स लाइक श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासन सो दैट साधन विचार इज देयर The next topic is Virodha Pariha means there are doubts. And how Tat and Tvam can be one? How an individual being and Brahman are one? Generally, what we think that I am different from Brahman. I am different from Supreme Reality. At the most, people say that I am part of this supreme truth. But all these great statements, they say, no, no, you are not part. That thou art. You are that. So there are questions. There are doubts regarding this oneness. So that Virodha Pariha, this is one topic. By proper logical thinking, all these doubts are eliminated. Questions which are raised are answered. So that is a very interesting topic, Virodha Pariha. And once all these doubts are gone, and that person is very clear about this oneness, he practices Sravana Manana, etc., and finally reached to that ultimate truth. Then he becomes Jivan Mukta. So the final topic which is given in our Adhyatma Shastra is Jivan Mukta Lakshan. Characteristics or qualities of a liberated person while living. Vedant doesn't believe in the liberation after death. Vedant believes that you can liberate yourself here now. In this very life. So those people who realize this truth, they are called a Jivan Mukta. And their lakshan also are given in all our scriptures. So these 9 topics are given in all the Shastra. And in Vivek Chudamani also, all these topics we see that Bhagavan Shankaracharya in great detail described, explained. And the beauty of this Vivek Chudamani is, it is a very, in a very poetic way. Shankaracharya, poet, a philosopher, and most importantly, he is a realized master. Charmingly he writes all the verses. When we read it and study it, we enjoy those. All sweet verses. And his language is not very difficult also. Sanskrit. Very flowing. Now, Vivek Chudamani, the meaning of Vivek Chudamani is crushed with jewel of discrimination. Vivek means discrimination. Chudamani means that jewel which is studded in the crown. It's called Chudamani. Here, what is the implied meaning of this Chudamani? That this Vivek is the final thing which we must take up. And discrimination or vivek, here discrimination doesn't mean racial discrimination, color discrimination, caste discrimination. Here vivek means what is truth and what is not truth. What is reality and what is non-real. Now this capacity has been given to us that we can differentiate, we can separate. Continuously, actually, we are doing vivek at every moment, at every step. But the highest kind of vivek is atmanatma vivek. And our all scriptures, they give importance to this vivek. Otherwise, in our daily life, we do vivek. I must eat this, I should not eat this. I must go there, I must not go there. So these are all vivek, types of vivek. But here he says, what is true identity, you must know. And what is false identity? When we know what is real and what is false, then we can remove ourselves. We can detach ourselves from false things. So that has been given very nicely in this book. Now, he starts this text with the explanation of glory of human life. Jantunam narajanma durlabham. And he says that three things are very rare in this life, and that is human birth, then having got birth in this human body, if you have mumukshutva, burning desire to know the truth, that is very rare. And if somebody has got that desire and he gets one teacher, Mahapurusha, that is also a sign of grace of God. So three things we get by grace of God. Devanugraha. Then he emphasized on the self-knowledge. He says, you cannot get any peace of mind just by acquiring so much of wealth. Amrutatvasya na ashasti. There is no hope of immortality by getting more and more wealth. You can get immortality by understanding your true nature, which is immortal. So by self-knowledge, one can get amrutatva. And therefore, one must try to get this knowledge. So with a lot of emphasis, he has been, you know, telling all the seekers that don't delay. Today only you start. And he said that person will be fool who doesn't know that where his welfare and well-being lies. He must understand that his welfare lies in self-knowledge. Because other knowledge cannot make you permanently happy. That's why he says, Uddhared Atmanatma. In verse number 9, in Bhagavad Gita also, same word has been given, same word has been used by Krishna Bhagavan. So here he says, Uddhared Atmanatmanam Madram Sansara Vadido. Lift yourself by yourself. If you want to get salvation or liberation. And he says, see, by different actions, we cannot get self-knowledge. Na danena, na snanena, pranayama shatenava. By hundreds of pranayama, if I do, anulom, vilom, kapal, vahati, brahmari, and bhastrika. People do, a lot of people, you know, they are doing all these things. So it is good for their health, no doubt. It has got its place in our life. But by doing pranayam, one cannot remove his ignorance about himself. See, by boat, you can cross a river, but that boat cannot, you know, run. You cannot drive that boat on the road. You have to leave that boat in the river itself. Everything has got its place. By spoon, I eat something. So it is a means to eat, but I don't eat that spoon. I leave it out. Same way, dana, snana, pranayama, by which I can purify myself. It has got a lot of positive impact on my personality. There is no doubt about it. And they are required. But to remove ignorance, only self-knowledge is the right means. So therefore, he says, ato vichara kartavya. That's why one must take up inquiry into the truth. And we must start thinking about ourselves, about world. But you know, it is very difficult to think on our own. So what he says, we must go to the teacher. But before that, he says, we must develop some qualities. Fourfold qualifications. You must have heard of sadhana chatushtay. Fourfold qualifications. I hope you remember those four. Vivek, Vairagya, Shamadhi, Shatasampatti, and Mumukshutva. These are the qualifications, you know, needed to enter into this spiritual path, and especially to Vedantic path. Now, all these things, in some proportion we have. Vivek we have, discrimination. We have got some Vairagya also. That's why we study. Otherwise, if we are completely attached to the world, then we would not have studied these, you know, texts. So some Vairagya is there, dispassion. Now, in details, he has been given the detailed explanation of Vairagya. Vairagya doesn't mean that detachment from objects of this world, but he says detachment from objects of other world also. Iha mutrartha phala bhoga virag swarga bhogeshu iccha rahitya dehadi brahma paryante yanitte bhoga vastuni. All those impermanent things which are not which cannot satisfy my demand of permanent happiness, so leave them, develop dispassion. Now, if you look at this world or other world, the nature of all the sense objects is same. Even in Swargalok also, little elaborate, little more joy you can have, but it cannot sustain for long time. Shine punya marti loke. So therefore, we must try to get that permanent happiness, and which is there in our self, in our true self. So Vairagya should be there. Now he said, Shama, Dama, control of mind. With distracted mind, we cannot understand what is Atma, what is Brahma. So, Svalakshe Niyata Avastha. I must be able to concentrate, focus on desired goal. Laksha. That is Atma. So Shama, Dama, control of sense organs. Sometimes what happened? Mind is in a peaceful state, but sense organs, they become so violent, they become so agitated, so they disturb the peace of my mind, and they drag mind to with them. Mind is beautiful, but my tongue wants, my eyes want to see. So then what happened? It forces my mind to go out. And sometimes other way. Sense organs are quiet, shant. But my mind is disturbed. So mind wants to become extrovert. So my sense organs, you know, it disturbs my sense organs. And through sense organs, it goes out. So shama, dama, they are closely connected. If one is controlled, other can be controlled. If one is disturbed, other will be disturbed. So shama, dama. Both the names of control only, but control at the sense level, organ level, it's called dama. Mind level, shama. Then one more thing is needed, very much required in the life of seeker, and that is titiksha, forbearance, fortitude. There are situations which are not conducive, which are not very favorable. So in such times, I must be able to maintain my quietude. That is called titiksha. Sahanam sarva dukkhana. Apratikar purvaka. Without revolting, without fighting, without complaining, just, you know, patiently, I must be able to withstand that. That is called titiksha. By fighting that situation, you cannot get over that. So better just wait. That's why in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna says, Agama paino anityaha tan titikshasva bharata. Shitoshna sukha dukkesha. Shita, ushna, sukha, dukkha. They will keep coming. The nature is that they will come, but at the same time, they don't stay for long. They go. Like all the clouds, they come in the space and they go. So we have to just patiently wait, that's all. So this is called titiksha. Then he says Shraddha. Shraddha is the main thing. If Shraddha is there, all my sadhana becomes so smooth. And even it takes that momentum also if Shraddha is there. If Shraddha is not there, faith is not there, faith is shaken. Then whatever I am doing, I will have doubt that I should do it or not. Is it right or not? So this samshay, doubt, is very dangerous. Therefore, he says, Shraddha is that a special quality, special point about Shraddha has been given, and that is, Sa Shraddha Katitha Yadvi Sadvi Yaya Vastu Palabhyate. Shraddha is that by which I get that final thing. Yaya vastu palabhyate. In other qualifications, he has not said about shama, dama, etc. He has not said. But about Shraddha, he says, if Shraddha is there, you definitely you are going to get that. Shraddha is the main, quality which makes that seeker move. If Shraddha is removed or gone, then I will not do anything. I will lose my interest. And it is true with all our empirical, you know, world also. When you go to college, go to school, if you don't have any faith in teacher, then what will you learn? You will not give any attention to the teacher. So Shraddha is that connecting, you know, factor which connects me with the final truth. So Shraddha is there. And Shraddha means whatever teacher is saying and whatever scriptures are saying, it is right. Today I may not be able to understand, but whatever he is saying is correct. So this vritti, this thought is called Shraddha. Then when Shraddha is there, then concentration will be there. It is called Samadhan. Samadhan means concentration. In Marathi, samadhan means satisfaction. In Hindi also, there is santosh. बट इन वेदांत समाधान मीन्स कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, सम्यक आधानम, सर्वदा स्थापनम बुद्धे शुद्धे ब्रह्मणि सर्वथा, फोकसिंग ऑन शुद्ध ब्रह्म इज कॉल्ड समाधान. सो व्हेन आई लिसन टू डिस्कोर्स आई मस्ट हैव दिस समाधान. When I am doing meditation, that time also I should have samadhan. And if samadhan is there, then I can experience samadhi. See, samadhi word comes from samadhan. Samyak adhan. Complete focus, total concentration. So, shama, dama, titiksha, sraddha, uparati. Uparati means swadharma anushtan. Doing duty, whatever duty has been allotted to you by scriptures, by teacher. Then we said, mumukshutva, burning desire. And now Shankaracharya talks about this mumukshutva later on, where he said that different types of mumukshu are there. Tivra mumukshu, if they want liberation right now. Intense desire is there, burning desire, Gurudev used to say. Like some pain is there and I am suffering from that, some disease. I want doctor now only, not after 2 days or 3 days. I want to get rid of, you know, that pain at this moment only. Same way when bondage becomes unbearable for you. Now I can't remain in this state of grief and state of bondage. I want liberation now only. So this is called Tivra Moksha. Like Nachiketa, like even Arjuna. They did not postpone. Then Abhivatai. Like emergency, and emergency situation is there. Tivra Moksha. Then Madhyam, mediocre. Some people say, yes, yes. We will study all these things. Once we get time, once I get retired, then only. That is called Madhya Mumukshu. Manda Mumukshu. Dull Mumukshu. There is no emergency in there. He said, Dekhenge in the next life, you know. There is no hurry. Manda. And Atimanda. Atimanda doesn't know that there is something which is called as moksha or liberation. He has no idea of Atma or Brahman. He is living in such a thick tamas. He is bhogi or he is papi. So he has no interest at all in this. Atimanda. But here he says, if the tivra moksha is there, then only one can get liberation. Vairagya and moksha should be tivra. Intensity should be there. Vairagyam cha mokshattam tivram yasya tu vidyate tasmin neva arthavantasyu phalavantam samadhi. When vairagya and mokshattva is tivra, intense, then only shama, dama, etc. they will have, you know, right, what to say, good effect on our personality. Or finally, you can say that they can be fruitful, phalavant. Otherwise, shamadama has got no value. If I control mind and sense organ, but no mumukshutvam is there, then what is the use of that control? So, phalavanta, shamadaya. Now, once he gets all these qualifications, you know, yogyata, now he wants to get that knowledge. Like when we enter into medical college or engineering college, so all the tests, all the exams, you know, when he clear, then only he gets admission. So here also now he gets admission. Now the problem is, he has got all the qualifications, but he doesn't know where to get that knowledge and how to get that knowledge. So Shishya Lakshana is over. Then Guru Lakshana comes into the picture. He goes to various satsangs, he goes to various Mahatmas, scholars, philosophers, and asks, please tell me, what is this world? What is Brahman? What is me? And by God's grace, he gets one teacher, Bhagavad Kripa. And then beautiful explanation of the teacher has been given. Shanta Mahanto Nivasanti Santo Vasantavad Lokahitam Charantaha. See poetry. He says all these gurus, they are like Vasantaritu. When Vasantaritu comes, all the plants, they are blooming, all the flowers, they are there. Entire the nature beautifies, decorates. So same way, these great people, wherever they go, the atmosphere of that place becomes so charming, so delightful, so positive, that the agitations and all the problems of that mind go away. So that seeker, when he approaches such teacher, he just surrenders. And he says, Katham tareyam bhavasindhu metha. How can I cross over this samsara? And is there any upaya? Is there any means by which I can liberate myself? All the bondages can be removed. Do you have any solution for that? And I know that you have got. So Krupaya, please. Please bless me with that knowledge, so that I also can become liberated like you. So that seeker surrenders at his feet. Now that Guru Lakshana is over, he says very nicely, actually, so many verses are there. When teacher sees that, yes, this person is a really genuine person and he wants the self-knowledge, so he assures, teacher says, Mahesh, don't be scared. Don't think that you will always be bound only. This world will entangle you all the time. No, there is upaya. Yenaiva yata yatayosya param. By using that upaya, many yati, many saints, they have crossed this ocean. Like Krishna Bhagavan also says in Gita, Bahavo jnana tapasa utamad bhava magata. Bahava, bahava is many. It's not few, one or two, many, many acharyas and mahatmas and great seekers, they have realized the truth. So that marg, that path by which they have gone to that final goal, I will tell you. Tava nirdishami asti upayo. And in one verse he says, now that seeker or the disciple is so eager to know, what is that? So Guru in one line says, Vedantarth vicharena jayate jnanamutta. Tena atyantika sansara dukkha nasho bhavati yamu. Bhavati anu. Bale Vedanta vichar, by Vedantarth vichar, jnanuttamam, that knowledge will be, produced, you will get that knowledge. Rise of knowledge will take place. And this knowledge will remove ignorance. And then you will be free from this world. So Vedanta vichar is there. But to get this knowledge, what you must have? So it says, Shraddha, Bhakti, Dhyana, Yoga. Actually, this line comes in Kaivalya Upanishad. Hey, one beauty of this Vivek Chudamani is many Upanishad mantras are put in these verses. All these Upanishad verses are woven in these verses. And Guruji very nicely said, if somebody reads Vivek Chudamani first and then reads Upanishad, so what he will say, you know, are from Vivek Chudamani all these, you know, words and mantras are given in Upanishad. Upanishad has taken mantras from Vivek Chudamani. If somebody reads Upanishad later and first Vivek Chudamani, but one who knows Upanishad and then he reads Vivek Chudamani, he will say, oh, this verse is from Kathopanishad. This line is from Mundakopanishad. So beautifully, Shankaracharya introduces Upanishad in Vivek Chudamani. Now, Shraddha, Bhakti, Dhyana, Yoga, this line comes in Kaivalya. Like one line is there which comes in Ashtavakra Gita. Mokshasya Kaamcha Yadivai Tavasti. Ashtavakra Gita start from that verse. Here also he is using that. So he is introducing other Upanishads, scriptures in this Vivek Chudamani. So teacher says, if you want to get Vedanta Jnan, you must have Shraddha and Bhakti. Shraddha is faith, Bhakti means devotion. Now one thing I must, you know, tell you. When we study this Vedanta scriptures, we must have devotion, love. We should not be dry-hearted, you know, stone-hearted. I mean, there is no emotions. We should not become academician, only scholar. This book talks this about this Atma, you know. Tattvavod says this, Atmavod says this. Only this intellectual knowledge will not take us to final. I must connect myself with this knowledge. I must surrender. Otherwise, what happened? It happens like, you know, like a study, like how other both physics, chemistry we study, same way Vedanta also we study. It is not that type of study. It is not intellectual gymnasium. It is not intellectual entertainment. We must see that all these things are happening in my life. And there must be some love for God. Because due to His grace only we are able to understand. So here Shankaracharya say that bhakti should be there. We should not be shushka, you know, emotionless, feelingless. Generally, it happens sometimes. A teacher should be there with him. We should connect. We should surrender. We should have a lot of devotion for him. So, Shraddha Bhakti Dhyana Yogad Mumukshu Mukter Hetun Vyakti Sakshat Shruter Hetun. Shruti says that bhakti should be there. Now, disciple, he understands. And he says, Shishya Vacha. He says, Guruji, I love you. I have got full dedication and devotion for you. I don't want only intellectual understanding. I want to abide in that. So, whatever you see, say, I will do it. Agyakari, obedient. That's why they say one must give up his head to God, to Guru. Kabirdaji says, Sir utaro bhui rakho, tapar rakho paap. Meaning, cut your head and place it under the feet of Guru. If that much readiness is there, then you can understand it. Meaning what? No ego. Surrender means what? Egolessness. One Swamiji very jokingly used to say, surrender means what? इन हिंदी उसमें से सरेंडर मीन्स सिर को गुरु के अंडर में रख देना, पैर के अंडर, पैर के नीचे, सर अंडर, सर मीन्स सिर, मीनिंग नो ईगो. अदरवाइज वेरी स्ट्रेंज थिंग हैपेंस, पीपुल डेवलप ईगो ऑफ दिस यू नो नॉलेज ऑल्सो, दैट आई नो मोर देन यू, आई नो दिस वर्स, आई नो दैट वर्स, I have by hearted complete Gita. So it will not be very beneficial for that seeker. So Shishya says, I am ready to do whatever you say. And now tell me, I have got some queries, some questions. Now these are all spiritual questions. Now what question one must ask, that also we should know. If some competent teacher is there, and if I ask him about my business and my family problems, then actually you are not doing right thing, because he is expert in self knowledge. Better ask him about that. So that's why in verse number 49, some example of question has been made. Which question he is asking? O nama bandhak katamesha agata. Disciple asks, what is bondage? And from where this bondage came? What is the source? Then why it is staying? Why it is not going away? Then what is Atma? I heard about Atma in my different, you know, satsang. But what is actually Atma? And what is Paramatma? What is the difference between Atma and Paramatma? Are they both one or they are different? So all these questions he asked. The teacher is so happy with the disciple's question. You know, teacher also expects some quality questions. If only superficial questions he is asking, then teacher will understand that his mind is not of highest order. Because, you know, question indicates our status of our, you know, mind, where we are, what we are. So he is asking very deep questions. In Bhagavatam also, that teacher is so happy when Parikshit Maharaj asks that what must be done at the time of death. If somebody is going to die in 1 week, what he should do? What a question. So Shukadevji there answer, oh, beautiful question you have asked. And this will be beneficial for all. It is not your private question, it is universal question. It will be helpful for all people. So here also, Guru is happy with that disciple and he said, oh, dhanyosi, krutakrutyosi, pavitam te kulam tvaya. You are blessed. You are fulfilled. Now see, by question only, he says you are fulfilled. Means you will get that ultimate fulfillment. Then you have purified your family. See, pavitam te kulam tvaya. And you want to become Brahman. Generally, people want to become millionaire. They want to become sport person or what, musician or artist or businessman. But Brahma Vaitum Ichchasi, hardly anybody wants. Very rarely people want to become Brahman. So definitely you are going to do to get that, because your question indicates that you have done some contemplation, some preparation. I will explain to you how you can get it. And then he says one beautiful point, that, you know, if you have to realize, if you want realization, you will have to do that. Thinking, listening, on your behalf, other person cannot do that. That point he has brought very nicely. He says somebody is sick. Is not well. Now on his behalf, other person cannot take medicine. One who is sick, one who has got disease, he has to take that medicine. Pathyam aushadha sevacha kriyate yona rogina. Arogya siddhi drishtar asya na anya anushtita karmana. He will have to take medicine, and proper medicine, right medicine. Same way here also, if ignorance has to be removed, right knowledge should be gained. And he says, na yogena, na sankhena, na karmana, no na vidya. All other means fail to remove ignorance. Only brahmatmaitya bhut. Only identity between Atman and Brahman can give you liberation. Other all these schools of thoughts, you know, Nyaya, Sankhya, Yoga, Vaisheshika, and all these, by that you can develop your intellect. Your buddhi will become sharp. To some extent, you will get purification of mind. And after death, you may get some higher world. So all these achievements are possible. But Brahmatmaikya Bodhena Vina Moksha Na Siddhati. Then he says, only by word meaning, only by studying word meaning, you will not get liberation. There are people, they can give good discourse, they can write books. So they have got the talent or art, but doesn't mean that they can realize or they have realized. Because it is an art. There are, you know, professors in the university, they teach all these philosophies. Shankaracharya says this, Ramanujacharya says this. So by having this knowledge at only intellect level, cannot help. That's what he said, Vag Vaikari Shabdadari. Very ornamental language or words he is using, Alankarik Bhasha. Very impressive as far as the discourse is concerned. But Vaidushyam Vidushyam Tadvat Bhuktaye Natu Muktaye. He will get a lot of praise. People will honor him. But if he doesn't actually apply all that knowledge to his life, he will not be liberated. Only as an art, you know, he is speaking, that's all. So therefore, one must try to live, imbibe that, you know, assimilate, digest, then only liberation is possible. Then he says, by saying that I am Raja, I am King, one cannot get kingdom. By doing japa that I am King, unless and until he kills all enemies, he cannot be called as emperor. He cannot get that kingdom. Same way, just by saying Brahma, Brahma, or by talking or by discussing about Brahman, you cannot get that Brahma Jnana or realization. For that, you will have to do sadhana. It is not an academic, you know, some kind of knowledge. Some people may get degree in Vedanta. There are people, they get degree also. They know all the Upanishads, all the verses of Gita and all that. But vina aproksha anubham brahma shabdirna muchyate. Without direct knowledge, liberation is not gained. Then he says that one must introspect, go within, and whatever teacher has said, try to think about it. Tasmat sarva prayatnena bhobandha vimuktaye. Putting forth all efforts, one can directly understand that I am Brahman. Then, after having said lot of, you know, thing about Brahma Jnan, importance of Brahma Jnan, necessity of Brahma Jnan, he actually starts. Because the disciple asks, from where I should start thinking if I want to reach to that Brahman, where to start? So he said, you start from thinking of your body, physical body. So he explained what is this body, because this is the gateway, this is the starting point. If I have to go within, the very first thing I meet with, this is body. So what is this body? Majjastimeda palarakta charamatvaka. From here actually the thinking starts. That this body is nothing but there are seven elements. Tattva of this gross body, you know, bone is there, blood is there, skin is there, assemblage of all these things, marrow, and then different limbs are there, heart and kidney and liver and head and all that, hand and leg, pada, uru, aksha. So this is anga. Medical science, you know, they do study of this gross body. So they are expert in it. They are a heart specialist, eye specialist, kidney specialist. So this is gross body. And now what happens, in this gross body, I have developed myness and I-ness. Aham and mama. Wrong notion, erroneous notion. And that is the cause of bondage and all the problems. Aham mama iti prathitam shariram mohaspadam sthulam iti riyate. So you must have studied all this, and how we are caught up in this gross body. Gross body become me. I became this gross body. There is no discrimination, you know, remain. There is identification. Actually, body cannot be me. Very simple logic. Because body is gross, inert, and I am conscious. No, I am living being. And I know this is heart, this is head, this is. So knower is always different from known. Very simple. So two things. One is jad and other is chetan. All these things is jad, inert, and I am chetan. I know. Hand and legs, they don't know. Knowership is not there. Awareness is not there. So how can that be me? Awareness and consciousness should be in me, means I should be that. And this body is continuously changing, and I am seeing the changes. So the seer should always be changeless. Then only he can see the changes. So I am changeless, body is vikari, I am nirvikar. But because of ignorance, both of them become one. When we go to some doctor, we don't say, the doctor, I have brought one body, just check it. I say, I am not feeling well. Please check me. Actually, what I should say, I have brought one body. And please examine. But no. See, in body, there are two notions are there. One is, it is me and it is mine. I and my, aham and mama. Both are signs of what? Ignorance. So this is the gross body. Then he gives different examples that how people are, you know, get attached to this world. But the starting point is this body. If I am detached from my body, then I will be detached from world also. Actually, world is nothing but extension of this body. If you go to market, you will see all the shops. Different articles, different things are kept there. And they are all for body only. You go to supermarket, you go to mall. All the things there which are connected to my body. If somebody develops detachment towards this body, then he will not be very much interested in going to different markets. Is it true or not? Because he is a little thing. Not so many clothes and so many items, you know, eatable items. Roti, kapda, makan, a little bit he will manage. But if I am totally attached to my body and give so much importance to body, then continuously I want makeup and I want different dresses and food and this and that. So that he is, you know, talking about. And then slowly he talks about sukshma sharir. And one of the verses he says that even attachment to one sense object can, you know, take you to different problems. He has given example of deer and moth and elephant, and you must have studied that. Fish, they die because of only one weakness for shabda or sparsha or rupa or rasa. Therefore, he is suggesting that better develop dispassion and become sadhaka, seeker. Okay, I think we should stop here. Tomorrow I will talk more about it and further what he is talking. So today, up to gross body, we have discussed. Yes. See, whatever we have heard or we have been listening, we should try to see in our life that is it true. For example, detachment. I was talking about detachment. So I must introspect how much detachment I have developed. What are my weaknesses? Where I am going wrong? So, see, practice, you have to practice only. It's for practice. There is no other thing. You have to start practicing, simple. Means, see, practice can be possible only, first thing is, if you remember what you have heard or what you have studied. The first thing. And for that, continuous listening is necessary. Then second thing, we can make a daily schedule that for half an hour, I will just sit quietly. I will make my mind peaceful. I will focus on what I have studied. I can take one page or two page every day. I can read it. That can be my sadhana. Then to develop concentration, I must start doing some japa. It is one round of that mala, 108 beads. So, I can develop that concentration, focus, and more purification. Purification will come to you already through japa and all. Try to do something by which you connect yourself with God. See, some people do puja, chanting some stotra. So doing all these things, you will develop that confidence. Yes, I am doing something and I am progressing. Just mere studying and, you know, understanding this thought will not give you satisfaction. So some kind of japa, some little puja, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and sit quietly and try to recollect what you have heard. This recollection also helps very much. And then if every day you don't have class, then every day you read one page or two pages and try to remember it. So these are small, you know, practices we can do. And again, when we study, then immediately we should see ourselves that how much I am practicing this thought or this point. practical things are there, kama, krodha, lobhamo, they should be given up. So, for example, anger. We should see why I get angry, how much angry I get, means for how long. If you remember this and try to see, then definitely you will reduce your anger, you will reduce your these modifications. Otherwise, what happened? Intellectually, we study, we know that this is called anger, this is called desire. But we should try to see in daily life that yes, it is creating problem. Yesterday, somebody was talking, a great seeker, he was talking to me, and he said, whenever my mind is agitated, I commit a mistake. Now, this is the analysis of so very good. This is small realization, you know. Realization doesn't mean one day some Brahman will be there. Small realization, small understanding. So she said that when I commit mistake, my mind definitely was not in a peaceful state. In agitated mind, all the wrong notions, wrong decision come. So I must develop that peace. So in this way, there are some tips are there. Tomorrow I will tell more about it.